the wrong crowd get us in trouble. Here's number nine. You don't, she says, you don't really appreciate me now, but just wait until I close my eyes and I'm no longer here anymore. Was mother right? Yes, we all miss our mothers whose mothers have gone on to be with the Lord. We wish mama was here so we could sit down and appreciate her more. We wish mama was here so that we can share our accolades and that we can demonstrate our love toward her more. And that's why she says that you must love her now, because there will come a time when she closes her eyes that she's no longer here. Was mother right? Yes, she was right. And what should we do, preacher? Praise your mama while you still have her today. Praise your mama. Give her praises. Tell her how you love her. Tell her how you appreciate her. Don't let her come and stretch out in a funeral in front of the pulpit before you realize what you had. William Bell says, you don't miss your water until your well run dry. Tyrone Davis said, I wish I could change my mind. But let me tell you, mama is right, and she is forecasting in your future. Praise your mama while you have a chance. She means you all of the good. Number 10, and finally, a mother's prophecy upon her children might say this: you act like you don't understand me now. Just wait until you get grown. Was mama right? Yes, mama was right, because grown folk now understood what mama was trying to do with them while they were children. And sometimes children don't understand what mama is talking about. You go on and get grown. And when you get grown and have to pay taxes and file income taxes, and when you get grown and when you got to pay for your own, you'll find out that mama was right. Mama comes from a special universe. Mama has what we call the Mama University. And if you can graduate from Mama University with yes, Lord, thank you, Lord, you're going to be successful in life. Getting grown really helps us appreciate what mama said. We look back over our shoulders and history of our lives. When we get 30, 28, 38, 45, 55, 65, and it makes us really thank God that we had a great mother to prophesy. Mothers sometimes are dead and gone for 10, 20 years, but some of us can still hear our mother's instruction in our mind. And we thank God that we have hands that have molded our life and gotten us to where we are. So, King Lemuel, King Solomon, what else would you have to say in closing this message? King Solomon, if he were here, he would tell you this in Proverbs chapter 22. Train up a child in the way that he or she should go, and when they are old, they can't get away from it. They can still hear their mother's voice. Mother was right. She wants the best for her child. And then I hear Solomon's daddy saying, I've been young and now I'm old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. Let me close this message by commending our mothers for what they have done and putting Jesus Christ into their children's heart. It is a story about Jesus Christ that when people come to church, they are inspired, that when life gets them down, remember what Jesus went through, how he sacrificed with his love out on Calvary, and they put him down under, but can't nothing hold Jesus down. He did an antihistamine demonstration. He got up from death, hell, and the grave, and you can rebound too, because he got up and passed the victory on to you. So when you press, remember what Mama said, when you press down, life is heavy on you, remember what Christ has done. He rose again. He rose again for your good. He rose again for your victory. There ain't nothing that ought to hold you down, for your mama has prophesied over your life. Remember what she has said and done to you. Come on, give God some praise in the place.